Hello everyone, my name is Rashmi Meher, I'm from Dr. Reddy's, and today we are honored to have Dr. Sunil Kutty, Brain and Spine Surgeon, Apollo Hospital, Navi Mumbai. We welcome you, sir.
Hi.
Sir, as we know that today we are celebrating World Head Injury Awareness Month, that's 20th March, it is celebrated. So I would like to ask you a few questions about it.
Right.
My first question is, how is brain injury different from other kinds of injuries in the body?
Brain injury is different from other kinds of head injury in the body, primarily because once a part of the brain, a neuron, dies, we can never recover it. So that is the most important thing. The damage is usually irreversible. So whatever we do has to be done on time so that we prevent that. So there are two aspects to it. One is primary brain injury and the other is secondary brain injury. Primary injury is at the time of impact. There is an impact, there is injury to a part of the brain, and that is gone forever. But a secondary injury is somewhere where we come into play. So secondary injury comes up because of lack of blood supply to that particular part, because of swelling to that particular part, maybe because of seizures that happen following head injury. So secondary injury is something which is largely preventable. Primary injury is also preventable in the form of taking safety measures largely. So prevent the head injury in the first place would be prevention of primary head injury, while the measures that we as doctors take would prevent further secondary injury. So what makes it different is the irreversibility of it also. A part is damaged, it's damaged forever. That is why we have to prevent that damage in the first place.
And so what are the major commonest causes of head injury that you come across?
The commonest cause, because of the change in the entire, in the last century, we've started traveling faster. So that is one of the most common causes. So we have high speed cars. So think about an injury that can be caused from a bullock cart hitting each other to a fast car ramming into each other. So that is the difference that has come forth. So most common would be a road traffic accident. The other would be fall from heights. So buildings have grown really taller now. So if you look at the fall from heights lead to head injury. Then there are times you have sports injuries, very rarely though, because of good protective gears. But still, even in sports, so boxing is one place, cricket is the other thing where head injury is possible. So these are two, three, and then the freak things. I mean, a tree falling on you, a freak of May. I mean, those things are also possible. But it's most common would be a road traffic accident, and then the other thing would be like, you know, fight between two individuals. So you start hitting somebody with a stick, and then that leads to head injury. So these are the more commonly encountered forms of head injury.
And so, as we talk about road traffic accidents, would you please tell us about what is the golden hour concept and how important is that?
As I told you about primary and secondary injury, so golden hour concept comes with respect to preventing secondary brain injury. So there has been a brain injury now, okay, a primary injury has taken place. So as soon as the injury takes place, the brain starts swelling up. There is a large clot sitting inside which is compressing the brain, preventing good supply to the brain or causing brain herniation. So before the damage becomes irreversible, we should try and intervene. So that is the concept of the golden hour, where the idea is basically to intervene as quickly as possible. So golden hour is taken as an arbitrary we actually managed to make it something called golden hour, so that there is an idea in the head that it has to be done quickly within an hour. So the main idea is that everything that you do from that point on should be as quickly done so that further damage to the brain is prevented. So secondary injury prevention is largely the concept behind golden hour.
And so we as common people, if we hear about any road traffic accident, we generally feel that it's only head that is affected, but basically the spine is also associated with head.
I mean, any head injury, okay, any road traffic accident can cause injury to any of the organs of the body, it can cause chest injury, abdominal injury. So along with the brain, spinal cord injury is also very common. And these are the two injuries where we come into play directly as neurosurgeons. We work on both the brain and the spine. So any injury associated with the brain or the spine is something that we deal with on a regular basis. Apart from that, chest is another big organ which can be injured. Abdominal injury is also pretty common with road traffic, plus long bone injury. So it is not just restricted to these two things, but these are the two places where we have a direct role to play. A head injury is dealt with by a neurosurgeon. A spinal cord injury is again dealt with best by a neurosurgeon.
So in today's time, as a society, we are putting a lot of pressure on these food delivery boys, and so they're putting their own life at risk and others' life also. So what is your take on that?
I mean, not just the food delivery boys, the way we function also, we also function under a lot of stress as human beings. So the key would be to maybe follow the traffic rules better. That would be the first thing. Whether you deliver the food on time or not, the traffic rules have to be respected. The red signal means the red signal where you're supposed to stop. Then the other thing would be in terms of preventive measures like wearing a helmet, so it's compulsory for everybody. But I think most of the food delivery boys at least follow the concept of wearing a helmet. But then there is a commercial aspect to it which people are trying to exploit. But then if, we know that it, at some point it is causing, it is bringing about a risk to that person's life and the other people on the road. So, something which should be curbed, not encouraged as such. These are corporate policies which have to change. So something, it's not something that I would really recommend to people that, you know, we try and deliver things within half an hour, you should reach within half an hour, you get it for free. That's not something we should try and encourage as such. So the other thing is maybe legislation. So whatever happens at the end of it, we need a strong legislation to come in. I mean, helmet at one point of time, everybody knew a head injury means you're injuring the brain. Helmet can protect you, but still most of us never used to wear a helmet till the government made it compulsory that you cannot ride a bike without wearing a helmet, or you would have to pay hefty fines if you don't wear a helmet. So legislation has to be in place. Maybe at some point the government has to come in and say you can't have this kind of a thing going on.
And so lastly, what would be your message for the society on this day?
As far as a message to society goes is our life, if you ask me, is becoming fast, but then everything has to be taken with a pinch of salt. You have to be careful about things. Preventive measures are available. I mean, one thing, if people start wearing helmet on their own on a regular basis, I mean, just because the cop is around, you carry the helmet and when he comes, you start wearing it, is not the way to go about it. You should try and wear it. If you inculcate those small habits, then, if you ask me, when I'm driving with my kids, okay, the moment the red signal comes up, they're the first one to point out that it's red, stop. So if that percolates all the way down to each one of us, I think we would go a long way in preventing head injury and preventing life damaging. You know, I mean, the whole family is affected because head injuries usually happen in younger patients. So, I mean, they are the source of income. Apart from that, a lot of hopes and aspirations attached with them. So what happens? The whole family is destroyed with one young man getting injured or a young lady getting injured. So we need to take that seriously. So the only thing is, from our own side, you have to be careful. There are kids, who hang by the train. I mean, just for the kicks they derive out of it. But then the thing which should be curbed. So legislation in one place, secondly from your own self. So as far as the society goes, you have to be careful. Brain injury is irreversible, so you have to really protect your head. There is no doubt about that.
Thank you so much, sir. We all are going to get benefit out of this. Thank you so much for your valuable time, sir.
Thanks a lot. Thank you.